time we were watching it.
Partying
all night.
I'm a promoter. I'm working. Look, I like
18,000 followers. You know who got followers? Jesus.
That's funny.
Jesus cursed. What would
Jesus say? Jesus would say, shut the fuck up. This is mine. Okay, that's funny. That couch just bluffed itself. Whose crib is this, man? Steve Jobs is dead, fool. I mean, his house
died. That's stupid. That's kind of funny.
Shit, Cleveland shit, LA shit. Damn. Sick the city, bro. Oh, my God. We in the Brown house. LeBron,
who?
James.
Hey, you're a one handsome motherfucker.
He got a hologram of himself just to give him compliments?
You handled the decision to go to Miami perfectly.
Nah. That's a cat.
That's kind of funny.
By next week, I gotta pay for my daughter's school. Bruh, they on vacation.
How about we throw a party
in the king's house? We gonna invite all the
celebrities. Just like kid to screw something up. But not kid play.
We just had this preschool, college, whatever. Tonight is our last shot.
Looks like we about to throw up.
Hi, I see you there. Don't worry,
it's a white man.
Oh shit.
Is LeBron home?
By the way, Black Lives Matter.
They do.
I posted two squares on my Instagram.
Oh, my God.
This is a really bad idea.
I wouldn't do something like this unless I was desperate.
She cracking, bro.
Oh,
the action's half a minute.
You gotta pay homage to the original OGs, bro.
You good? What the fuck just happened?
But I don't see it going anywhere.
Anyone who says otherwise is just jealous.
This guy.
But I don't see them making a second or third.
Oh, yeah, it's already like. We probably watch all the funny parts.
Yeah. And that probably all happens in the first 15 minutes. I don't see it going. I don't know.
House Party was the original deal, bro. You know what I'm saying? And the dudes that did the show, like Kid and Play, bro, they were more than just actors in a movie. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They were hip hop artists that made a movie about, you know, not it wasn't based on their life, but their culture.
Yeah.
And their craft. And it just made sense for that time. It just don't make sense for right now.
It don't.
It doesn't. Just trying to relive the old days and try to bring it back, but just leave the old days where they're. I don't know. I'm not feeling it. It was as some funny stuff. I mean, but you could have made it a different movie about something else.
It's like
they could have just called it something else.
Yeah, like they remade the Fresh Prince. I still haven't watched that.
Nah, they did a good job on that.
Did they?
Yes, I'm not gonna lie. The new Fresh Prince is a different show. It's not a remake.
It's just a. Or
it's a remake because it's all the same characters. It's based on the same characters. It's a remake.
Oh, okay.
The same storyline, same plot, and everything like that. But they modernized it, and it's really they brought it up to speed for today.
Okay.
That show. I'm not gonna lie. I want the second season to come out already because
I haven't watched it because I was afraid that it would just ruin.
No, it's different.
Childhood.
It's a whole different show.
I mean, like, real slapping Chris ruined my entire childhood.
Yeah, that kind of messed us all up.
So, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. The new Fresh Prince was good. I thought it got renewed for another season, but I don't even know because is it on Peacock?
I think it is on Peacock.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it got renewed for a second season. It was actually really good.
Yeah,
it's a little overly dramatized with some things, but I really liked it. It was actually really entertaining. I enjoyed it. I didn't enjoy it like I did the old ones. The old ones were just different, man. They were just. You can't remake that.
Yeah.
You know, you're not going to have that. So what they did was they put a more modern touch to it, made it more relevant for today, and it was all right. It was all right. I liked it a lot.
That's cool.
So, but yeah.
Well, I know
We'll talk some more about that stuff, like going over new shows, old shows, and stuff like that, reboots and whatnot.
You know, one movie that I wish that they would remake and make it better, because I don't think the movie, even at the time, was that great of a movie, is Ghost Dad.
I love that movie. I don't know why. I like that movie. I remember watching it a lot when I was a kid.
I mean, I watched it a lot as a kid, too. But it was
Bill Cosby. So it was kind of like...
I didn't think Bill that...
He's a rapist. He's a convicted sex offender. So it's like, you know, isn't that messed up?
Yeah, it is. Like, he was the best doctor, the best dad, the best... You know?
He was America's dad, bro, for a while.
Yeah.
America's dad's a rapist. Like,
damn.
It's messed up, man. He was doing it. He got caught later on, bro.
Damn.
That's like R. Kelly, bro. I mean, R. Kelly wasn't always wholesome, don't get me wrong, but...
I mean, I believe R. Kelly's songs was him telling on himself.
I sang that song during my junior high school graduation. We was all like, I believe I can fly. Woo!
Bro. Like, people still sing that in churches. Can you believe that?
Oh, I never heard that song in the church. That's kind of funny.
I've heard that. I've heard that in the church.
They couldn't come. They had no other hymns. They was like, we're going to hit... And the Lord said,
I believe I can fly.
and with that, the choir is going to have a piece by Sir Reverend R. Kelly.
I've heard it in a church.
Oh, bro, that's a little bit ghetto. That's kind of... Oh, I never heard no other song besides church songs that mention God and Jesus and heaven and referring to like was it sung during the praise and worship part? Was it sung towards the end, like after the sermon? Was it after the sermon? So
we gonna ask Sister Louise to come on up and give us some peace.
Oh,
sister, what you got for us today?
Brother Eugene. Can we get a piece? We got a special presentation today. Dick and Reginald is gonna sing us a song today. oh man, that's messed up.
We're gonna ask the children's section to stand on up and join in on us with this song.
The youth choir is gonna have a piece.
The youth choir is
gonna have a very special piece. As a matter of fact, they got to visit the artist who wrote and performed this song originally a couple weeks ago down in Syracuse. Well, the church was on a special parishioner's retreat, and it was a very momentous occasion. You know, some of our young females got to visit with the artists. You know, they had their own. Yeah, so in commemoration of that time, we decided to go ahead and sing one of those songs from this artist. And that artist, he's here today. If you could stand up in the back. Oh, there he is. Okay, I see you, boy.
Mr. Robert
Kelly. Yes, that's right. Uh-huh. Yeah, thank you very much. Now, he's kind of a busy man, so I don't want to bother him too much. You know what I mean? Don't y'all all start going to bother him, okay? He won't be here after the service when the church has dinner. So, the females are going to go ahead and do one of his numbers, okay? If y'all don't mind. I know it's a little unorthodox, but, you know, Jesus was a little unorthodox, you know, because he was a Jew. But he was an unorthodox Jew. Can I get an amen? Can I get an amen? And the church sang.
Yeah! Oh, man.
Bro, I believe I can fly at church.
We won't pass the offering.
I kind of said they changed the words around to like, Mr. Robert. I believe Jesus Christ. But if it was the original, I can fly if I just spread my wings. I can fly.
All right. Pause.
Anyway.
What, you had your moment?
Okay.
You had your moment. I'm going to need you to bring it back down.
I'm going to tone it down. I'm sorry. Damn. I took it too far.
That was.
But he's a rapist, bro. Or, I don't know what he's convicted of. Sexual assault.
Sexual misconduct with the juvenile.
And statutory rape.
Yeah.
Statutory rape.
With several juveniles.
He's a sex offender.
Yeah.
But his songs, bro. I mean, I like the other stuff, too, though. Don't get me wrong. But I like the other was good. Stuff.
He couldn't dance.
Step in the name of love. Come on, bro.
Well, I mean, yeah.
It was all step in the name of love.
Yeah. Yeah, the chocolate factory was...
It's the remix to Ignition.
Hot fresh out the kitchen. Mama rolling that body. Got every man in here wishing. Sipping on coke and rum. I'm like, well, I'm drunk.
Okay, I don't know the rest of the words.
Oh,
but that was, man, that song used to hit, bro.
I used to listen to that whole album.
Crystal popping in the fresh nap.
You don't know the rest of the word, but you want me to sing the whole thing?
Sorry.
I used to listen to that whole CD in my 1991 Cadillac.
Is he on Spotify still? I'm just curious.
He probably got taken off of everything.
Nah, let me see. I'm going to look him up.
Because he would still be making money.
Well, he got to pay his victims. Oh, he's still on.
He's still on.
Sure is.
Everything.
What? Hold on, wait. Let's see.
You know, I was really looking forward to R. Kelly. You know, when they were doing the verses.
Usually I don't do this, but go ahead on, break them off with a little previews of the remix. Now I'm not trying to be rude, but hey, pretty girl, I'm feeling you. The way you do the things you do reminds me of my neck is cool. That's why I'm all up in your grill, trying to get you to a hotel. You must be a football coach, the way you got me playing the field. So baby, give me that do-do. Let me give you that heat. Running her hands through my fro, bouncing on 24s. That's why they say I'm ready. It's the remix to Ignition. It's hot and fresh out the kitchen. Mama ruling that body, got every minute in your wishes. Is it been on coke and rum?
Now, the thing is, we all thought that she was talking, that he was talking about a strip club.
But that toot toot and that beep beep part, I feel like he was luring little kids. You know what I'm saying? Toot toot, yeah. The beep beep, you know what I'm saying? It's like, I don't know.
We thought he was talking about a girl in a strip club on a pole. But the whole time, he was talking about the playground.
Mm-hmm.
Damn.
Mm-hmm.
Damn.
Damn.
For like my whole life.
Damn, he has so many songs. Life. I forgot about all these songs.
I had to fight.
Dang. Trapped in the closet. There probably were
trapped
some.
In the closet.
There probably were some females trapped in the closet.
Was it like 9 trapped in the closets?
I don't even know, bro.
R. Kelly, the only one that's still trying to get out the closet.
For real.
Everybody then blasted him out the closet.
Mm-mm.
Anyway. Damn.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to end this podcast now. Because... Yep. It's been a long time. We got things to do. We'll touch more on our heroes. Let's not get started with Michael Jackson, bro. I don't care. I feel like whatever he did, he might have did it, but he didn't do it enough to be mad. You know what I'm saying? So.
Oh, man. What's his name?
So he ain't doing it to no black babies. It's all his. You know, he ain't started that stuff till he turned white anyway. So, anyway.
Anyway.
Smooth yeah. Criminal.
Damn.
All right.
I'm a smooth genital.
Penny, are you okay? anyway. All right. All right, you guys.
Yeah. Love, peace, and chicken grease. I'll let you, boy.
See ya.